Hello everyone and welcome back to another video, my first one in 2 months to be precise. Anyways, in today's video we will be ranking Angry Birds Epic classes based on their vitality to the game. Is it good early game? Is it good late game? On its own, is this class decent? Questions like that. Price won't be a factor just because that makes everything way too confusing for one video. Also, if you enjoy this video, make sure to subscribe as we're actually getting pretty close to reaching 10k subscribers. With that being said, let's get started with the tier list. First up, we have Red's Knight. In my opinion, it isn't bad. Its attack is as average as can be, and the shield you get is fine, I suppose. As a starter class, every ability is pretty simple, but that doesn't necessarily mean they're bad. However, Angry Birds Epic just isn't built for something like the Knight. As you get further into the game, shielding and healing every ally at once becomes a big priority, and the Knight just can't handle late game situations like that. So, for our first class, I would have to put the Knight in C tier. Next up is the Guardian, which is hard slept on by most people. Its abilities on their own aren't too good, but pairing them together makes them amazing. A 4-turn shield for every bird, yes please. Not to mention, reducing the attack power of enemies by 25% when attacking them is really nice. I've used this in almost every challenge I've done, and there's a good reason why. It's way more versatile than you originally think. B tier for me. Samurai is next, and that just goes in S tier. It's really simple why. Dragon Strike is multi-hit, and the shield you get is incredible. Continuing on, we're now on to the Paladin. I would probably say high A. Although it doesn't really give you any direct shields, the healing you get when attacking is unrivaled. It's like having a mini Matilda on your team while still being able to deal any semblance of damage. But if we really want to talk about damage, the Avenger is where it's at. I mean, look at those numbers. I think it's pretty obvious where this class goes. Yeah, no, it sucks. In fact, it's one of the worst classes in the game. If you want to deal any damage with this class, you gotta be at like 1% health. And as you get further and further into the game, you cannot rely on being a glass cannon to contribute to your team at all. This class is absolute garbage. Now, the last class is the Stone Guard. I've never really played this class before, so I guess I can just base it off of its raw abilities, which, looking at them, they seem pretty good, all things considered. Feral Assault seems like a pretty good move, and Ancestral Protection is fine. However, since the damage reduction effect on enemies only hits after they attack your flock once, I don't really know the viability of it, but I'll just keep it as a high B tier, I suppose. And now we're on to Chuck's classes. First up to base is the Mage. It's just not that good. It's yet another starter class, which means its abilities are simple as always. Chuck is generally a squishy class, but most of the time looking at neat abilities a trade-off. Well, not in this case. The Mage's Storm deals pitiful damage as a shock shield, although useful in the early game, becomes useless as it gets outclassed throughout the entirety of the game. Low C tier for me. Now for the Lightning Bird. I would say low A tier. It's kind of needed for up until the second castle, but it kind of falls off meta after that and is never used again until the Chronicle Caves. Paired with some other select birds, this class can actually become a powerhouse. There are still some better options for other circumstances, but I think the Lightning Bird, even on its own, is pretty decent. Here comes the Rain Bird. Easy S tier. I don't know if it gets much use in the Chronicle Caves, but everywhere outside of that, it kind of dominates. You can attack every enemy at once while using 2/3 of your available turns in a match towards healing the entire flock. It also clears all negative effects of the target bird you use your healing on, which is just a cherry on top of the cake. Would I say it's better than the Samurai, though? That's kind of tough since you're really comparing two birds who have completely different uses, but for now, I'm just going to keep Red in first place. After the Rain Bird is the Wizard. Where's the Wizard? Oh, right here. Pretty average, I would say. I guess I'll just keep it here. I would say that it's, like, a little worse than the Lightning Bird because, again, you can just get that extra hit to using your other target birds with Lightning Bird, unlike the Wizard. But the Wizard itself is honestly fine. It could do with a buff. If Energize proc'd on every bird at once, I would probably move it up to like A tier or something. But for now, like the effects you get, like 20% chance to stun an enemy, I just don't think it's good enough to move it up to the higher tiers. So B tier it is. Next up is the Thunderbird. This is another class that I have not played, like the Stone Guard, but I think its abilities can speak enough. It's kind of just an upgraded mage now, isn't it? Again, in some aspects, it's miles better, but why use anything mage-related when the Rainbird exists? From my very limited viewpoint, B tier. I could be wrong on that call, though, so correct me on this one if I'm just dumb. And for the final one of Chuck's classes is the Illusionist, and that goes into high A tier. Mirror Image is really where it's at. Creating a clone of your allies is just really good. I'm not sure about S tier good, but I think this class can handle the Chronicle Caves, especially the later ones, with relative ease, which means it gets my seal approval. A tier it is. Matilda. Her starter class is the Cleric, so I suppose I'll lead with that. I think that the Cleric is underrated. It's not the best, but it's not bad either, like other people say it is. I've used the Cleric in a lot of the challenges I do, and that's just because you can get both healing and damage out of this class. Healing Strike scales with your weapon strength, and her healing shield when facing enemies like Demonic Whispick can quite literally make you invincible, as the 15% damage taken converted into healing can stack between every bird. However, since it falls off late game, I would have to put it in B tier right below the Guardian. Still isn't a bad class though. The Druid is also pretty good and continues the tale of good early game classes, as it really works during the main campaign of the game. Regrowth is a solid healing move, and Thorny Vine just allows you to get that extra punch some of her other classes are lacking. I personally don't use this class as much as I used to, but if you are playing the game normally, you can't go wrong picking the Druid. A tier, I think, is good for it. And next we have the Princess. Ooh, this is such a niche class. The Princess focuses on healing a singular ally, while its main attack just forces every enemy to attack the ally with the most HP. On paper, it's not a horrible class, however, there just aren't many situations where this class comes into use. Throughout the game, enemies will deal damage to every bird at once, and when that happens, the Princess literally can't do anything against that. Its healing is fine, I suppose. I mean, honestly, it can't even handle regular overworld levels that well. I think I'm gonna put it in low C. I think, again, it's niche. It can go above disappointed tier, but C tier, low C tier is good for it. But a class that will go into low D tier is the Bard. It looks good on paper like the Princess, but it just falls apart when you really look at the details. The healing you get isn't enough, and the 15% chance to stun enemies literally means nothing. By the time you would stun an enemy, they would already be dead several times over. I know there are people who like this class, but I just can't put it high. I just have to stick it a D tier. Now this differs from the Priestess, who immediately goes into S tier. Just like the Cleric, this class is reliant on dealing damage to enemies while still creating spirit links for your allies. It's a bit more tougher, but when you master this class's playstyle, the rewards are just so worth it. Since the Priestess's healing is based off on maximum HP, it just never becomes bad throughout the game. Additionally, Angelic Touch can proc multiple times per bird, which means that if you have enough chains on your allies, you can heal the HP of the entire flock in a singular turn. It's just so good. But as our final Matilda class, we have the Witch. It also goes into the D tier. I'm keeping Avenger on the bottom of the bottom, but Witch is not very far away. Imagine Princess, but just even more niche. You don't get any direct healing for all your allies. It's just really Giant Growth that does all the work, and even then, it's such like just a meme-y move that it's just not viable, and I can't really recommend it to people. It may be good in the arena, I wouldn't know. I don't really play the arena that much. But from what I've seen, this class just kind of sucks. On to Bombs classes. The Pirate is a starter class, and as the trend goes, it's kind of bad. The attack boost you can get is decent, but it gets outclassed by other status effects so quickly, it's only used for like 10 battles in the overworld. Its main attack is pretty simple as well. High C tier, I think. Again, it's not really unusable. The Cannoneer is also just a really average class. Its main ability being a multi-hit is really nice as always, and having a counter on a bird early into the game is always appreciated. However, since his counter scales off of allies' attack power, I can't really put it into ARS. High B tier, I would say, but it certainly isn't a bad class to use. Next is the Berserker, who goes right next to the Pirate. It is a class, that's what I'll say. I mean, you can get pretty good damage as your Rage Chili charges up, but when you use your Chili, the Berserker goes right back to dealing pitiful amounts of damage to anyone. His secondary ability sucks as well, as it just doesn't do anything. Period. 15% of your health is near nothing, and for all enemies to take that same amount of damage just counts as a waste of a move to make. I suppose it could be used for ghost battles, but again, just use any of Chuck's classes. But now we have the captain, so the captain's pretty good. I would honestly say high A. I'm putting it ahead of the paladin. His abilities are good. Raid clears all positive effects from enemies, and his secondary ability literally boosts an ally's damage by 60%. I'm not 100% sure, but I think this is one of the strongest secondary abilities in the game, just based on damage alone. His secondary ability just lasts for 3 turns as well, so it's just really good. You can't go wrong using this class, it's great. But where you can go wrong is the Frost Savage. Like other classes, it may seem great on paper, but it's so RNG dependent that I can't really put it into the higher tiers. However, the fact that his freezing barrier applies to every bird puts it above D tier. So, low C it is. Finally, we have the Sea Dog. I've seen people do Alpha Pig with the Sea Dog, and there's a good reason why. Combining a secondary ability with set bonuses and other birds makes this class an absolute powerhouse. There's really not much doubt about that, but if we are ranking each class on its own power and just its own abilities, it just isn't that good. The fact that it loses damage over time as your rage truly charges up just is a giant drawback from using this class, and so I would have to put the Sea Dog in B tier. And with that, we only have 6 classes to go with the blues. Starting off with the Tricksters, it immediately goes into high A tier. It's such a good class. Its primary ability clears all effects from enemies, and its secondary ability not only clears the effects of every bird on field, but also gives them 15% extra damage. This bird is so good, it's literally needed for Wispig's castle. Like, if you don't use it, Wispig will just regen to max HP from all the effects you receive in the first wave. Now, if you're wondering why this is an S tier, that's just because there's better blues classes out there. One of which is not the Rogues. The Rogues, all things considered, are a pretty average class. Just imagine combining the Druid's Thorns and the Princess's Targeting ability with Chuck's Shock Shield just mixed in for some extra spice. The fact it reflects 100% of the enemy's damage is pretty good, but I don't think that qualifies for an A tier class, so high B it goes. Next up is the Marksman. Yeah, that's a pretty easy S. Volley gives enemies a status effect that effectively doubles your damage output for 3 turns. Not to mention, it's a multi-hit. The secondary ability is whatever, but the Marksman's attack is just so broken, I love it so much. Actually, this combo right here, the Marksman, Priestess, Samurai, works pretty well for most battles all the way into the Chronicle Caves. Again, all S tiers, except for Rainbird, but these S tiers at the very least are all multi-hit classes. There's a bit of a pattern there. But anyways, now we're on to the Spies. They're as average as you can get. Again, they kind of have a Chuck-esque attack of dealing damage to every enemy at once, so that's neat. Their secondary ability gives you some healing as well, scaling off of your damage, which is also pretty neat. I'm just going to plop it in the middle of the tier list. Again, I really don't have any opinion on this class at all. But now we only have 2 classes left. The second to last class is the Shulkers. I'm putting them in, like, the mid-A tier, I would say. Trixie Trick is great since you can distribute crazy effects to every pig within the span of a single turn, creating some pretty interesting possibilities when playing the game. Is this class necessary to progress throughout the game, however? No, not at all. But I still think it's pretty good. But if you really want to talk about good, we're ending off with the Treasure Hunters. They go to the top. The very top. They are, in my opinion, the number one class in Angry Birds Epic. And that's just because they can literally revert the charge bar of enemies. That's such a good ability. There's not really much more to say about it. Untouchable is pretty good as well, reflecting effects from enemies for 3 turns is totally not broken at all. But yeah, I think I can confidently put the Treasure Hunters in S tier. You cannot convince me otherwise. The Treasure Hunters is just that amazing. And I think that's it for Every Bird Ranked. Now, it's important to realize that my tier list is just an opinion, and depending on your experiences or playstyle, you may have a wildly different opinion than me. But with that being said, other than some of the classes I haven't played much, I think this tier list is mostly fine. The neat thing about this game is that even the class in the lower tiers can still be useful to an extent if you use the right combos. Like the Avenger. It sucks, but if you pair with the Captain and Princess, it honestly isn't horrible for certain levels. And I suppose that's the cool thing about Angry Birds Epic. Every class can be used well, and so I guess in the end, this tier list doesn't mean anything. So I suppose with that, this video has come to its end. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, or if you didn't, it doesn't really matter. Comment down below what you would change about the tier list, but yeah, I'll see you all next time.